Here in Adobe Audition, I am going to record some audio here, right? Which I want to do, okay? First off, what I want to do is choose the track that I want to record into, which happens to be track one. I'm going to go ahead and arm it with record, right? So we're ready to go. Next off, I want to make sure that I have the right settings, okay? Right now, this is going to the Samsung microphone. Yours might not say this, right? So you have to go into, let me do this again. I'm going to cancel this. Go into this pull-down menu for the selection of audio input. We're going to hit hardware preferences. And what we are going to do with audio hardware is that we are going to make the default from the built-in microphone to the Samsung microphone like we're using in class. So if we make this, it's going to use the Samsung. If you don't do this, it's going to record the audio on the screen and it's going to be lower quality, which you do not want. So you click OK. Next thing we want to do is make sure we have everything selected, and we want to record mono because this isn't stereo, right? So we go ahead and do Samsung CE1 mono, which is great. Okay, so now it's going to record mono. If you don't do this, you're going to have some audio issues that you're going to have to fix. Okay, now next thing we're going to have to do is actually turn up or down the gain of the microphone being recorded. We do this through our system preferences on the Mac. So if we go down to the dock, we open up System Preferences, we go to Sound, we open this, we have all these, input is what we want, right? We gotta make sure that the Samsung is selected, right? And then we can, as you can see, turn it down, the VU meters here barely moving, or we can turn it up to where we want it to be, which is probably gonna be somewhere right here. Now, because we're recording mono, they're both coming in at the same strength, and that is what we want, okay? So I'm good to go here, I'm gonna close out of that. Get back to here, and I'm going to record some audio, which right here. So I'm going to go ahead and hit record and record the audio. I am recording some test audio. This is a test for the audio that I am recording. I'm recording this as a demonstration to the class on how to record audio. I'm going to hit the space bar to stop. I can also hit stop down here on these controls. So if I play this back, I am recording some test audio. This is a test for the audio that I am recording. I'm recording this as a demonstration to the class on how to record audio. Okay, now, there's some things I don't want in here. As you can see, there's a big space. Test for the audio that I am recording. All right, we have a big space right here. This is a test for the audio that I am recording. Okay, great, so what I want to do is actually split this and do an edit right here, which I can do in here pretty easily. I can right click and I can go to split. As you can see, it's also an command K, right? So if I split this, as you can see, it splits the track right here. So now I can do some edits on here, right? So I am going to zoom in on the timeline, which I can do by pulling up this top area. And I can trim down this area and I can move this in. So now I have this edit. This is a test for the audio that I am recording. Right, and now we no longer have that huge space. Now let's say we want more space between here and this piece right here. We can do the same thing where we can split it, which I'm going to do a command K. Right, and there's the split. I'm going to zoom out. And let's say I want this part to start further out. So I can do it right here if I'd like.
I am recording some test audio. This is a test for the audio that I am recording.
And of course we have lots of space until we get into here.
I'm recording this as a demonstration to the class on how to record audio.
Now, something that I want you to do when you record your audio, and with most things that we do, is that we are going to put in little fades that are going to make the audio fade out. Because if we don't do that, we're going to get hard clicks, which we don't want. So we can do that by rubber banding, right? This line right here is actually a line that we can adjust the volume for, right? Okay. So what we can do, as you can see when we're on the line, we can add a plus sign here, If we double click, we get a keyframe. Okay, and I'll talk more about keyframes in class. I have to have two keyframes. This is where we start the automation and stop the automation, or what these two keyframes are. So if we want this to go down to zero to have a fade, we have something like this then.
Okay, I'm recording.
This is always good practice with any audio, because as you hear, when it comes in,
I'm recording this.
It just kind of pops in.
I'm recording.
So what we can do is we go in here. Once again, this is good practice for this class, right? Go over here. We go ahead and add a keyframe there. And take it down.
I'm recording this.
And that's a smoother transition there. In fact, I can just do the same thing right here at the beginning. Just for good practice.
I am recording some test audio. This is a test for the audio that I am recording.
Okay. So this is how we deal with recording. Now, you got to keep in mind, whatever track you have the R on is what you're going to record on. So at this point, I am going to take this off just to make sure that this works out properly. And that is how you set up the microphone and how you record audio and how you deal with the ending of the audio.